everyone. Aaron here for zollotech, and iOS 14.5.1 came out as a bit of a surprise early last week, as well as the previous Friday, iOS 14.6 Beta 2. Now, I've actually been using both versions on my iPhone 12 Pro Max. I was using 14.5.1, then later installed Beta 2 of 14.6, and then also had the same experience on my iPad Pro 12.9 from 2020. So I was having battery issues with iPadOS 14.5.1. I completely wiped the device like I said I would probably do if I was having issues, completely wiped it and clean installed iOS 14.6 Beta 2 and then restored. So we'll see how the battery did on that. And then also on the three remaining devices, they're all running iOS 14.5.1 on the iPhone 6S Plus, iPhone 12 Pro, and iPhone 11. Now, before we talk about the overall experience and the YouTube community poll, where you had a ton of great feedback talking about the experience of it, and I want to cover battery life and those sorts of things, one feature that's gotten a lot of attention is app tracking transparency. Now, with app tracking transparency, I'm already in it in settings, but you can get to it by going to settings, then privacy, then tracking. If you turn this on, you'll be prompted to allow different apps to track. If you turn it off, you won't get any requests and it just will block everything. So it's enabled basically either way. But some people are getting pop-ups from things like Instagram where they're popping up and saying, if you don't enable this, we may not be able to offer the app free in the future. I actually experienced this myself in Instagram. So I took a screen capture of it or a screenshot. Let me go into photos. And as you can see, it says you're on iOS 14.6. It requires us to ask permission to track activity. And down here, it says help keep Instagram free of charge. Now, this is a little bit deceptive since they're going to make money off of ads either way. So this is something that I would enable turning off app tracking for. It's not a new feature, but this feature is great. It stops applications from tracking you across your device. So I definitely recommend just turn it off if you don't want any prompts. If for some reason you want to allow them, you can turn it back on. So that's basically the new feature here, and that was enabled with 14.5 actually in use. It was enabled or in there before, but it wasn't enabled until 14.5. Now, as far as the overall experience, I'll first talk about 14.5.1, but if you want to jump to a different section, of course, the time codes are always in the description. Now, with 14.5.1, on certain devices, there's some speed issues when it comes to benchmarking. Now, whether or not these actually affect the device itself is yet to be seen, but when you go into Geekbench, for example, I booted this up and tried again, scores are unusually low for some reason. So the single core score is normal at 1,569, but the multi-core score is fairly low. A lot of people have been mentioning this, and this seems to be a problem. However, not everyone is saying that it affects the overall usage. So if you go into CPU and you'll see the different days, May 7th, I just ran it. The single or the multi-core score is quite low until we go back to the previous version on March 26th, where it was over 4,000 for the multi-core score. Now it's about half of that. And while that's just a benchmark of the device, Geekbench actually released an update to Geekbench when iOS 14.5.1 came out. And so I'm not sure if it's something Apple changed on the back end to stop this from actually testing properly or if it's something else. Many people say that they're having this issue, as you can see here. And also they say that they're not sure it affected performance. So it seems to be smooth and performing well with 14.5.1, but it's definitely an issue. As far as bugs, well, a lot of people are mentioning some bugs with 14.5.1, such as the phone getting overly hot. So whether you're using a 12 Pro or an iPhone 11, the phone is getting abnormally warm. Now, it will get warm when you charge it, for example, but for some reason, it just gets hot sometimes when you're using it, sometimes when you're not using it and it's not charging, it will get warm. And that will definitely drain your battery more quickly if you're having that happen. People continue to have issues with Wi-Fi and Bluetooth for some reason. Apple, for some reason, with 14.2 and on, Bluetooth just seemed to go downhill. So if you're having Bluetooth issues, you could still be having them even with iOS 14.6 as well. So there's definitely something going on as far as that. And also people are still experiencing problems with the phone freezing. So all of those things are in 14.5.1, but some people don't have any issues whatsoever. They're experiencing pretty great usage overall. Now with 14.5.1, the overall speed and everything, it doesn't seem to be affected too much for me on the 12 Pro Max, but on the 6S Plus, I did boot it up earlier trying something else. It's a little bit warm for some reason. I haven't been using it, and it's experiencing that same sort of thing I mentioned before. Now, it seems okay right now scrolling through things, but going into different apps, I did notice it lag quite a bit. So I'm not sure if they're doing something else on the background, if it's still processing or something else. Now, as far as overall battery life, I went through all of the comments in the YouTube community poll, and if you were running 14.5.1, I looked at that and then determined whether or not you said it was the same or better than iOS 14.5 or worse. 51% of you out of a couple hundred comments said that it was the same or better. 49% of you said that it was worse. That's actually very close to 50-50, and that's probably the worst I've seen it in a very long time. So it's definitely not amazing for some people on battery life, but for others it's fine. For example, my daughter and my wife have not complained about battery life at all, but others have. So it just depends. They're running that full time, but it just depends. Now, when it comes to iPadOS 14.5.1 and 14.6 Beta 2, despite wiping the iPad, it does not seem to have improved battery life. Performance has never been an issue on the iPad. In fact, it's performed great. I've had zero issues on these versions with the iPad. Battery life is the concern. And you'll see it was last charged on Thursday to 75%. And then over the next few days or couple days, it was used about an hour and 52 minutes. And then again, for that amount of time. So if I was using it for about 4 hours total, from 75% down to 9%, 60% of the battery with 4 hours of use is quite bad. So hopefully it improves. Maybe it's still doing some background tasks after completely wiping it, but so far it's bad as far as battery. Hopefully it'll improve soon, but it is on a beta now, but either way, it should be better. Before iOS 14.5, it was much better, or earlier on. Now, as far as my experience with 14.6 beta 2, it's actually been pretty good. I have had a couple issues with it. For example, airdropping something. Airdrop sometimes seems to be a little bit slow for me on my 12 Pro Max. Also, some touch responsiveness issues. Sometimes it just doesn't want to respond as far as speed and touching the screen. I'll have to tap an app a couple times. So I've actually reported these issues in the feedback app, and you want to make sure you do the exact same thing, because then they'll prioritize it and fix those issues. So I reported the touch issue, and the airdrop issue seemed to be more prevalent today, so I'll probably report that a little bit later today. But if you're having major issues, be sure to report that. However, those of you using iOS 14.6 beta 2, most of you, and I mean the vast majority of you, said that battery life is great, a big improvement over 14.5, for example. So a lot of you are saying that. So in general, many of you are having good experiences. Now, overall battery life on my iPhone 12 Pro Max, if we go into settings, and there's a little glitch there you might have just seen, go to battery health, I'm at 100%. I've been using this every single day, with the exception of doing reviews and things when the iPhone 12 and 12 mini and 12 Pro came out, but this has been my main phone other than that, and I'm at 100%. I charge it every night using a fast charger, a MagSafe fast charger, but I don't use a case, so it can vent the heat pretty easily as well. If we take a look at the last 10 days, it's varied greatly. You'll see this is pretty much when I installed 14.5.1, and then I switched to 14.6. But if we take a look at yesterday, it wasn't so great. 2 hours and 42 minutes of screen on time, 2 hours and 23 minutes of screen off time, and I used about 60% of the battery. If we go back another day, it's about the same. So I'm still not getting great battery life on this. However, I went to bed with 50% of my battery life left, and I didn't put it on a charger most of the day. So no issues there. I'm at 69% now, and well, I've been using it all day, so it hasn't been on the battery at all today. And today it has 3 hours and 20 minutes of screen on time, under 50% of the battery life. So generally, I feel like I'm getting 8 to 10 hours, no problem. And most people are saying the same. I'm not sure if it's reporting properly, and I would love to see Apple revamp this in iOS 15 to maybe report the last usage since charge. So when it was charged up to 97 or 100%, let me know how it's been ever since then without plugging it in or anything else, not just 24 hours. So hopefully we'll see something like that in the upcoming iOS 15 revision. Now, as far as if you should update to iOS 14.5.1, well, that really depends if security is a main concern for you, because it's a security fix. If you're not as concerned with that, well, then you might want to wait until 14.6 comes out to the public. However, I wouldn't advise updating to iOS 14.6.2 if you're looking to maybe solve problems with 14.5. If you have an extra device and you want to test it, or you're a developer, then obviously it's fine to install. But if you install it on your main device and have major bugs, that could be a concern for you. So it seems like something I don't generally recommend. But if you want to try it out and you know what you're getting into, I would try the public beta if you're going to try any of them. And as far as when iOS 14.6 will release to the public, well, based on what we think at this point, it looks like the end of May. On the 21st of May, for example, is when Apple is supposedly going to start shipping or delivering the new iMac, as well as the new iPad Pro. If that's true, we need iPadOS 14.6, since that's what added support for it. We'll need that on our iPhones and our iPads for support for those new devices. So hopefully we'll see it around that time. If not, they could have an interim update, but I expect it sometime around then, of course, with a iOS 15 with all the major changes in June on June 7th. And I covered that in a different video, what to expect there. So 14.6 beta 2 is pretty stable. And I wanted to share with you the statistics, and we'll look at some of the YouTube community poll comments. So here are the statistics about what people mentioned as far as battery life, lag, freezing, it being slow, it getting a little bit warm, and crashing. Now also, here's all the statistics about all of the devices you're using, and an impressive amount of you are using iPhone 11. I was surprised how many more were using iPhone 11 than anything else. And that makes sense. It's a very good value, has a fast processor, and I highly recommend it. Even though people say the screen isn't that great, I think it looks great, especially for an LCD, if you don't care about the OLED display. And also if PWM bothers your eyes, that sort of thing, then of course, this is the way to go. It has all the new features and it's the least expensive with all those features. But either way, it keeps doing the HomePod thing when I bring them close for some reason as well. So either way, it was impressive to see how many people were using iPhone 11. Now let's take a look at the YouTube community poll and we'll take a look at some of the comments. So we'll go to YouTube, and at the time of this poll, since I get ready for the weekend, you'll see 13,000 of you voted, which is incredible. And there are 286 comments at the time of this video. As you can see, 63% of you say that iOS 14.5.1 is great, or there were no changes between that and iOS 14.5. With iOS 14.5.1, 12% of you said that it had bugs or that it's terrible. With 14.6 beta 2, only 8% of you are saying that it's great or no changes, and 3% say that it's terrible. 13% of you are using something older or Android or a different operating system altogether. So it's pretty impressive to see 63% of you actually say that it was good or no issues noticed. And generally those with the main issues, battery life and things, will be the first to comment as well. So battery life is okay, but it definitely brings some bug fixes. And I think with 14.6, it'll get much better. Now, if we go into the comments, we'll sort by new and take a look at some of them. I showed you some of them in this video. So let's go ahead and take just a look at a few of them. And you'll see Akraf Tahir says iOS 14.5 was running great, updated to 14.5.1 and noticed some battery drain issues, so I rolled back to 14.5.1 while it's still being signed by Apple. iPhone 11 Pro. Hirak Ahmed says, heating issue solved. My iPhone was heating while playing PUBG. Now I was needed a tablet fan, but don't need it anymore. And I have a solution for your headphone issue. Go to accessibility, touch, call auto routing, then select Bluetooth headset. iPhone 12 Pro Max, 14.5.1. Paul Alvarez says, 14.5.1 has been buggy on my 12 Pro Max. Spotify and YouTube would freeze sometimes upon opening. Bluetooth connection is unstable with my AirPods Pro. Elvis Wu Knight says, on my iPhone 6S Plus, 100%. I'm just loving it on iOS 14.5.1. Sherman West says, working good on my iPhone 12 Pro Max using 14.6 Beta 2. No problem so far. Fast, the connectivity is great. Maria D says, I'm using iOS 14.5.1. The battery is slightly better than 14.5, but not as good as 14.4. I have 100% battery health, but it isn't lasting me as long as before. iPhone 12. I've had some app crashes and some not loading. I hope 14.6 fixes all of this, especially battery. I'll read a couple more. Xavier D says 14.6 beta 2 on my 12 Pro Max has hands down been the best beta to date. Battery life has been excellent, way better than the official 14.5 release, and performance has been great. Easily getting through the day, I'm usually up by 4 a.m. with 40 to 50% battery life left at the end of the day, usually 7 to 8 p.m. The Sad Panda says iPhone 11 with iOS 14.5.1 is doing okay. Battery life is still a little bad. Mario Goucher said iOS 14.6 Beta 2 on my iPhone 12 Pro. I don't see any difference compared to the 14.5 release candidate. Really stable for me. And so that's it for iOS 14.5.1 and 14.6 Beta 2. Like I said, look for 14.6 fairly soon based on what Apple is releasing hardware-wise. But I'd like to change up these follow-up videos a little bit and wondered what might work best for you. If you'd like to just see less information, if you enjoy the longer videos, let me know in the comments below. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.